Hello, let's talk about user input. Every program that is interactive somehow needs the ability to read input from the user. And Python has a special input function which we'll explore today. We will also take a look at how to convert one variable type to another variable type. Getting input from the user is really the key to making our programs interactive. And it's fairly easy. I am defining a variable here, and I will call it username because I want to let the user enter his or her name here. And now I'm just using the special function input. It works like this. I write input, and then in parentheses, I write, please enter your name. This is what the user will see on the screen. And when the user enters anything here, any string, it will be saved as the variable username. Now I want to say hello and put the name there that the user entered. So I will print out hello. You should already know how to do that. And I will add the variable username because that should contain the value that the user just entered. Now I just need to save it and run the script. See here, it says, please enter your name. I'm entering my name, Raz. And it says, hello, Raz, just as expected. So let's head back to our script. And this time, instead of entering a name, we'll let the user enter a number. You can see here, I will expand this print command a little. I will say, we will multiply your number by 7. And then I will define another variable. This time it's called user number. And I will use the input function again to ask for a number. I will write here, please enter a number. And then I will just print the line, your number multiplied by 7 is. And then in the next line, I will print another line with the actual number that is the result of the user number up here multiplied by 7. Now there's still a little problem here because the input function always treats user input as a string. However, if we want to multiply, we need an integer. So what we do is we convert it to an integer by writing int, int, parentheses, and then this whole expression in here, which is a string, and now it's converted to an integer, and then we close the parentheses. When we run this now, it should work fine. Here you go. I'm entering my name. Hello, Raz. We will multiply your number by 7. I enter 7. Your number multiplied by 7 is 49. Perfect. I'm going back to my code now. And I want to turn those two print lines at the end into one line. So I'm inserting the number right here after this statement, your number multiplied by 7 is. And here's my variable, my integer. But what happens if I run this now? You can see here I'm entering my name and hello, Raz, we will multiply your number by 7. I'm entering a 3. And this looks like an error message. And you can see here it says a type error can only concatenate string, not integer, to string. So as you can see, I have indeed added an integer to a string inside the print command, and that is not allowed. I have to use the same type of variable inside the print command. So I'm converting user number multiplied by 7 to a string. And now I'm running it and you can see I'm entering my name, I'm entering a number, and the final result is 21 as expected. Remember, we used int to convert a string to an integer, and we used str to convert an integer to a string. We needed to convert the string to an integer because everything that the user inputs becomes a string. We needed an integer to calculate with it. So we converted the string to an integer. We then converted the result, which was an integer, back to a string because we wanted to output a string combined with the result So whenever we put something into the print function, all of those need to be the same type of variables. They don't necessarily need to be strings. They could all be numbers. They just need to be the same. But since we wrote the text, we already said, okay, there's going to be a string here. So we had to convert the result to a string as well. So let's quickly summarize everything we learned today. We learned how to get user input by using the input function, essentially writing the keyword input, and then in parentheses, writing anything that should be displayed on the screen before the user makes an input. We learned that input always treats anything the user enters, even if the user enters numbers, as a string. So if we need anything other than a string, we need to convert the variable. And we can easily do that by using the int function, int, standing for integer, parenthesis, and inside the parenthesis, we put our string. A similar function exists for converting anything to a string, and that's the str function, standing for string. All we need to do is write str, and in the parentheses, we write the variable that we want to convert to a string. We also said that inside a print command, we can only combine the same type of variable. In our example, we used a string combined with a number which we converted to another string. That's all. In the next session, we will take a look at conditionals. See you then.